Hello students, having seen the law of demand, law of supply, now we shall look at the equilibrium between demand and supply. Equilibrium, when supply and demand are equal, that is when the supply function and the demand function intersect, the economy is said to be in equilibrium. Okay, we can see this figure in 3.4. The allocation of goods is most efficient because the amount of goods being supplied is exactly the amount of goods being demanded. So you have plotted this graph. You can see here one increasing. This is a law of supply, that is increasing one, and the decreasing line is for law of demand D. Okay. So where this supply and demand intersect, that point is called as equilibrium, and that quantity is called as a quantity of equilibrium, and P is the price at equilibrium. Okay. Thus everyone, the individual, firms or countries are satisfied with the current economic condition. At the given price, suppliers are selling all the goods that they have produced and consumers are getting all the goods they are demanding. So equilibrium means whatever, suppose Maruti produces 20 lakh cars, so they are able to sell all the 20 lakh cars, and there are 20 lakh customers who are interested in Maruti, and all are able to buy the cars in that particular year. So this is known as law of this equilibrium between demand and supply. Okay. So here what happens, you can see from the chart, equilibrium occurs at the intersection of the demand and supply curve, which indicates no allocative inefficiency. There is no inefficiency, means no extra cost of production or extra storage, inventory is not there. At this point, the price of goods will be P and the quantity will be Q. Okay. These figures are referred to as equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. But in real market, equilibrium can be only reached in theory. So, okay, so the all the price of goods and services are constantly changing in relation to the fluctuations in demand and supply. So again, I'll coming back to your manufacturing industry, say motorcycles and all. So what happens to promote sales? Then they reduce the price, okay, or they offer some more features. There are many ways, not only price reduction, so installment schemes, so they make the purchasing easier for the customer, okay, or they pay for the road tax. So lot of schemes and incentives are provided by the manufacturers, MNCs basically, so that they can retain the market and even grow, because they are all, as in the we have discussed in the economics, our intention is to minimize investments, maximize sales, and minimize the maintenance and operation costs. So accordingly, these all these companies, they have a lot of engineers, and most of the engineers now end up in marketing and sales also. So they find newer and newer methods to increase the demand. So this is the discussion about equilibrium between demand and supply. Even the fish, as I was given the example of fish, in the market when the fish, more fish comes, the catch is more, then definitely the prices fall down. Otherwise, the when the catch is less, then what happens? The fish's prices go on skyrocket. I think I have seen that. You may get something for 300 rupees kg, and in off season or less catch, it may go up to 1000 rupees also, 300 times more. So that is very much possible. So this is a simple explanation about equilibrium between demand and supply.